I'm Kevin, and today's episode of Creating Music, I'm here with Sean, a guitar player here at Lawrence College, and I'm just going to have you introduce yourself.
Yeah, my name is Sean Drinan. I'm a senior here at Lawrence College, and I'm from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
How did you get into, like, music, or what was that time where you thought, like, I want to get a guitar and get into learning how to play it?
Right. So my little brother actually played electric guitar, and he's really good at it. Summer of 2020, I broke my foot and I was bedridden. I could do practically nothing. So I thought, I got to keep myself busy somehow. I ordered a guitar on eBay for $100. And yeah, I just played that all summer and, you know, just pretty much nothing else. I've never been musically inclined before, so it was hard to learn, but it was definitely worth it.
What was your parents' reaction when you bought this guitar?
My parents were like, okay. I mean, they kind of know that my little brother is like the musical talent of the family, so I think their expectations were pretty low for me. You know, they were a little surprised just because I've never had any musical talent in my lifetime, but, you know, they were supportive of it, so.
And have you always been interested and wanted to learn, or it was an idea that just popped up one time?
I mean, I listen to a lot of music. Like, music is one of my favorite things, especially rock, alternative rock, classic rock. So I hear these guys shredding on the guitar. It's mostly electric that I listen to, but I've always been kind of curious as to, you know, how they're able to do those chord progressions and basically create the music. And I wanted to have some sort of part in that. So that was part of my inspiration for picking the guitar up.
Okay, for sure, for sure. And was it like a certain artist you looked up to, or a certain guitar player that like hinted towards you when you started that?
There were a couple inspirations. Led Zeppelin was one of the big inspirations. And then Jimi Hendrix, obviously, greatest of all time. I gotta give him some credit for creating that inspiration. And otherwise, just a couple, you know, smaller indie artists that, you know, aren't really big names, but I really appreciate their music.
What does your practice routine look like? I know, like, you came in with a phone and a certain app you used and to tune it. So what does your practice look like? Do you YouTube it? Do you just play with the strings?
Right. So, yeah, it's not very organized what my system is. It's a pretty ragtag system that I have. I got the guitar and I was like, okay, now what? You know? And so YouTube is the primary tool that I use to learn. I have very specific songs that I'll want to learn by, you know, Post Malone or just like the Lumineers, just various artists. So I'll look up how to play. And there are a couple artists or a couple YouTubers that are really good about laying out a lesson plan that makes sense, that you can easily follow. And so I watch YouTube videos, I follow along with those, and then after that, it's just a lot of repetition. You know, like, practice makes perfect. So I've improved just by watching those videos, learning some of the chords, and then repetition from that point.
Okay, and then I know you talked about you having a roommate that also played guitar. How did that relationship, like, come together, and how did y'all even know y'all even both play guitar? Did y'all both see each other guitars, or was it just like a conversation y'all had one time? And y'all just related to that idea of music?
So I'm pretty sure my roommate, Michael, and I, we met long before either of us even like picked up the guitar, before we either of us knew how to play. Mm-hmm. And I think we both sort of found it at the same time, but we didn't talk to each other about it until both of us were actually playing. I think I came back to school with my guitar, he came to school with his guitar, and we both just kind of like saw that, and it's like, okay, sweet. So, you know, we'll have some jam sessions in the living room where we try to find songs that requires like two acoustic guitars, and you know, neither of us are like a very like high skill level, but you know, it's, like I said, it's for our own enjoyment. We just kind of, you know, play around with it. So that's pretty much that.
So my very last statement, where do you see yourself going with your skill in the guitar? Do you want to, like, pursue music more? Or you're going to keep it more of, like, a hobby level type of idea?
I mean, when I originally got the guitar, it was just supposed to be something to, you know, keep my mind off of my broken foot. And it has developed as I've improved. You know, I think it would be really cool to be in a band, but I just never see myself having the time to invest into, you know, making my skills at a high enough level that I could join a band. So for the foreseeable future, it's probably going to remain a hobby. I'd love to get an electric guitar and, you know, learn some of those original songs that I drew inspiration from, like by Led Zeppelin and Hendrix. But I see it being pretty cemented as a hobby in the distant future.
Okay, well, thank you for joining me.
Thanks for having me.
All right.